Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss about marketing microenvironment. Before we have a look at the marketing microenvironment, we will look at the meaning of marketing environment. This is about me. A company's marketing environment consists of the actors and forces outside marketing, that means outside the team of marketing, that affect marketing management's ability to build and maintain successful relationships with their target customers. See, the foremost objective of marketing is to build and manage profitable and successful relationships with the target customers. So the actors and forces outside marketing could greatly influence the ability of marketing management, the ability of the marketing team in its move to build and maintain successful relationship with the target customers. Let's have a look at the meaning of microenvironment of marketing. The actors that are very close to the company affects its ability to serve its customers. The actors are namely the company or marketing organization. It refers to other departments of the company: suppliers, marketing intermediaries. Previously it was channel intermediaries, now it's known as very carefully marketing intermediaries, customer markets, competitors, and public. Let's have a look at the meaning of macro environment of marketing. The larger societal forces which comes in the broad environment that affect the micro environment of an organization. See, the actors that come or that fall within the micro environment, they affect the ability of the marketing department directly. Whereas the societal forces that exists in the next layer or in the broad perspective affect the micro environment of the organization, which in turn affects the marketing department, and that is what to be understood. What are all the societal forces that we can identify in the macro environment of a company's marketing management? Demography, economic, natural, technological, political and cultural forces. Just look at this picture. There are three circles drawn. Look at this. The circle which is in the middle, it represents the organization. It means other departments of the organization. We'll discuss that in detail. Followed by, within the second circle, you find the other actors who come under the micro environment of marketing: suppliers, distributors and dealers, who are none other than marketing intermediaries, customers, competitors, and public. Look at the third circle. It consists of the societal forces which influence the micro environment of marketing. What are the forces we have identified? The economy, economic forces, economic environment, demographic environment, legal environment, technological environment, political environment, social environment, and cultural environment. We will discuss about only the actors who fall within the micro environment of marketing in this video. Marketing management's job, the primary job, is to build profitable relationships with the target customers. How? By creating customer value. What is the customer value? A customer finds value in what he buys and consumes when the bundle of benefits he receives is more than what he expected. If the product or the market offer fulfills the expectations of the customer is satisfied. Only when the customer is delighted, that means when more than satisfied. When he gets more than what he expected, he finds value in what he buys and consumes. And therefore, it is the job of marketing management is to create customer value and satisfaction. That's the primary job. This job cannot be done by marketing team alone. Marketing department is not functioning in the bewildering jungle, and it is not to be kept apart from other departments or other actors which are related to the organization. The success of marketing greatly depends upon its efforts to build cordial relationships with the other departments of the company, the suppliers, marketing intermediaries, customers, competitors, and various publics, which combine to make up the company's value delivery network to its target customers. The value delivery network should be much better than that of competitors. For that, if the marketing department has to take a lot of efforts to build harmony and good relationship with all these actors, right, who fall within the micro environment of marketing. Now, the first actor who falls within the micro environment of marketing is the company. Company refers, as I said, the departments other than marketing departments in the company. In designing marketing plans, marketing team must accommodate the needs of other functional areas of the company to coordinate the customer value delivery effectively. As I said, you alone, the marketing department alone, cannot really provide a value delivery to the customers. It is possible only with the support of all other departments. When you all join together and form as interrelated or cross-functional groups in harmony, and it is possible for the entire team to come out with value delivery to the target customers better than that of competitors. See, the cross-functional groups, which consists of members from all the functional departments of the organization, is now and the newly named as internal environment. But it is not required to discuss it separately. Discussing about the other role of other departments, how they could influence the ability of marketing department in serving the customer satisfactorily or better than that of competitors, is discussed in micro environment of marketing itself. So there is no need to discuss about internal environment separately. Now let's continue with the same point. Marketing managers make decisions within the strategies and plans made by the top management. See, it is the job or role of the top management to set boundaries. Or it is the role of the top management which determines the mission and vision of an organization. You all know vision is the basic reason for the existence of an organization, or why an organization is given birth. And that's what very important. It is determined by the top management. So you, as marketing department, you derive your objectives and all that from the company's objectives, which are to be determined by the top management. So the marketing team should work in harmony with other departments like HR department, production department, finance department, sales department, purchase department, and all, which have an impact of the marketing department's plans and actions. So you cannot really decide about your activities, your plans and strategies without consulting or without coordinating with the other functional departments of the organization. So in a nutshell, all the departments should work together for providing superior customer value. Everyone in the company, irrespective of the department to which you belong, whether you belong to finance department or you belong to auditing department or accounts department or production department, sales department, everyone should think of only one person, who is none other than the consumer. who determines the destiny of the entire organization. The second actor in the microenvironment are suppliers. Suppliers form an important link in the company's overall customer value delivery system. If the suppliers do not cooperate with you in supplying the raw material, in supplying the input, whatever you know you require for making your market offer, I am sure your company, your production department will be handicapped. And it cannot carry out the production as it is planned. So the suppliers are the firms and persons that provide the resources needed by the company to produce the goods and services. Supply shortages are delays, labor strikes with the suppliers organization, and other events can cost sales, can reduce your sales in the short run. What about the impact of it in the long run? It would damage the customer satisfaction. Unless the supplier delivers whatever the raw material or input you have ordered for promptly, you cannot carry out your production plan as you have planned, as you have decided. The result of which, definitely you cannot meet out the demand for your product in the market. When you fail to meet out the demand for your product in the market, I am sure even your loyal customers will be forced to move away and choose your competing brand. No other go for them. Rising supply costs may force price increases that can harm the company's sales volume. And it is within the control of the supplier. If the suppliers have got the power to raise price for what they supply, I am sure it will lead to have increased cost of your production and making, and it will eventually have an impact of increase in the price of your market offer. This is another, you know, problem. If the price increases for products, if you are dealing with the products related to elasticity of demand, obviously the demand for your product will go down. If the price increases, demand will go down. Then the next actor who comes in the micro environment of marketing, the marketing intermediaries. They are the firms that help the company to promote, sell and distribute its goods to final buyers. They are the people who carry, carry the goods to the point of consumption. Perhaps they are the people, they are the organizations who fill the gap between the point of production and the point of consumption. That should be kept in mind. They include various middlemen like retailers and wholesalers and distribution firms, as well as marketing service agencies, including advertising agencies and financial institutions. All these organizations and individuals fall within the nomenclature of marketing intermediaries. Physical distribution firms, we know the role of retailers. Retailers are the people who meet the end users, the ultimate consumers, who come last in the chain of value delivery network. Their role is very, very important because they are the people who finally hand over your market offer into the hands of the consumers. They play a crucial role in the value delivery network. And who are wholesalers? They come in the above layer to the retailers. So wholesalers serve the retailers properly. If they serve the retailers properly, the retailers will be enabled to serve the end users appropriately. This is what to be understood. Now let's have a look at, you know, the rest of the institutions or individuals fall within this category. Physical distribution firms help the company to stock and move goods from their points of origin to their destination. From the point of production to the point of consumption, they involve in moving them from one place to another place, store them, till the time comes for the goods to move to the next layer in the channel of distribution. They store them properly, they preserve them properly, and that's the role of physical distribution firms. And in practical sense, it is taken care by dealers, distributors, in the market, in the FMCG or, in any product market, including pharmaceutical product market, I assume. Marketing service agencies are the marketing research firms who involve in doing research about customer satisfaction. To what extent our market offer is fulfilling the needs and wants of the customers. To what extent our product is satisfying the needs and wants of the customers in comparison with that of competitors. So they try to analyze. Either we could have our own marketing research, department to carry out this job, or we could depend upon the third party organization to involve in such activity on payment basis. Then advertising agencies, and definitely, and their creativity to a greater extent determines the success of a company. So meticulously, every company has to choose an innovative ad agency. Media firms, which carry the advertisements or the marketing communication to the level of the target consumers. The marketing consulting firms, they give consultation like in choosing a proper brand name. Name is very important for a product. Name. And we will discuss it separately when it comes to branding topic. It's a bigger area. In fact, brand management itself is a separate subject. So, like brand consultants and other consultants, in the name of marketing, they are also part of marketing intermediaries. They, all that organizations help the company, to target and promote its products to the right target market. The next one, financial intermediaries, includes banks, credit companies, insurance companies, and other business that help finance the business transactions of the channel intermediaries are insured against the risk associated in their business. Might be in buying and selling goods or in other activities involved in the job of marketing intermediaries. In the company's value delivery system, the company must partner effectively with the channel intermediaries to optimize the performance of the entire system. See, the contribution of every intermediary, right? Not one particular intermediary, all the intermediaries, like financial intermediaries, consultants, take other intermediaries, who fall within the category, all their contribution is playing predominant role in creating a successful value delivery system. Then the next actor comes within the microenvironment of marketing, customers, the boss of every business organization, who are always correct. Keep that in mind, the customers are always correct. Customers are most important actors in the company's microenvironment. The foremost aim of entire marketing system, all the content carries out, all the concerns, plans and executes, everything is targeted upon only one aspect. It is to serve the target customers better than competitors and to create strong and profitable relationship with them. That's very simple. The company might choose to serve any or all of five types of customer market. We'll discuss them, one after other. Consumer markets. The consumers are categorized into five different, markets. The first one, consumer market, consists of individuals and households that buy goods and services for their personal consumption. If you and me, we go to buy something, whatever it might be a toothpaste, might be a toilet soap, for our own personal consumption, we belong to the consumer market. Very simple. The next one is about business market, where you find goods and services are bought for further processing or for use in their production process. That means what? Whatever they buy become raw material or parts which could be used in their finished product, right? Then resellers market, where you find your wholesalers, retailers who buy market offers to resell them at a profit. Then the next one is about government market, where you find the government market is made up of government agencies that buy goods and services to produce public value, to involve in public services, to serve the citizens of the country. of a province or state. To transfer such goods and services to others who are in need of them, to the public who are in need of them. Like if a government buys medicines, you know, the medicines could be supplied to the citizens of the country. This is what very simple about. Then you find the last type of customer market, international market, where you find the buyers of other countries. I don't say buyers in some of the books they have written, buyers in other countries. No, buyers of other countries. See, now a company need not go out of the frontier of its home country to get into international market. In the globalized environment, even if a company doesn't go out of its home country's boundary, it meets some competition from the global companies and international companies in the home country market itself. See, you don't have to go out. They come into your country to compete with you. So obviously, the perspective of international marketing has to be redefined. This is what, you know, my perception about it. And the next actor, competitor. A company to be successful in its venture must provide greater customer value and satisfaction than competitors. I would simply say, respect your competitors. You value them. Do not underestimate your competitor. Do not underestimate your competitor. It's very simple. If you are able to compete with the competitor, you compete. Or you better acquire. Or put it this way. If you feel it's a loss-making exercise to compete with the concern, you buy it. Like the one how Facebook acquired WhatsApp. Facebook very properly judged that WhatsApp is going to be a bigger threat in the future. In the social media. So, understanding this particular fact well in advance, it acquired WhatsApp. It's very simple. The same thing, you know, was taken place in the soft drinks market of India. When Coca-Cola entered into India, it found Parle was doing a fantastic job among Indian consumers. It found it is a loss-making exercise to compete with Parle. Better to buy it. So it bought it. This is what either acquire or compete. If it is possible for you to acquire another concern, you acquire it. Otherwise, if there is no go, you have to compete. Now, Coca-Cola cannot, you know, acquire Pepsi. So, there is no other go than competing with Pepsi. It's not very important. And you be like a watchdog and observe what is happening with your competitor. You really compete with them. You have, you know, differences in the strategies, policies, everything. But obviously, you should be proactive in your approach. As a marketing concern, you should be proactive. Then only you can reach out to success. So the companies, therefore, must gain competitive advantage by positioning their offering strongly against that of competitors in the minds of consumers. See, the positioning which you promote by your brand in the minds of the customers are the unique place your brand wants, you want your brand to occupy in the minds of the customers should be much better than that of competing brands. So in such a way, you try to identify the list of competitive advantages in your brand and choose the best competitive advantage from the list based on which you develop positioning. And we will discuss about the requirements, you know, and the positioning strategy has to be fulfilled when it comes to a positioning topic. The size of the firm is immaterial here. Don't say that, you know, if a concern is a larger concern and it will have the possibility to find many competitive advantages with its market offer so that it can choose a better one and easily compete with the smaller concerns, nothing like that. How innovative your concern is, that is what very important. How innovative. If you develop a product, see, it comes from the root cause, where you start. How you started making the product? Did you properly understand the needs and wants, the left out needs and wants of the customer and design your product? If you have done it so, I'm sure here your job is so simple, so simple. And the last point is about public. Your company's marketing environment also includes various publics. Who is public? A public is any group that has an actual and potential interest in or impact on an organization's ability to achieve its objective. They can have actual or potential interest, or what? They can really influence your ability. They can have their activities will have greater impact on your ability to serve your target customers. There are 7 types of publics. I have brought out this table. This is my own, right? Type of public. What is this? Financial public, it determines or it influences your borrowing ability. If the investors don't come forward to fund your project, I'm sure your company will be financially handicapped. It cannot go further. So their opinion about you is very important. And the second type of public is media public. They carry news to the people. They are the people who spread either good or bad news about you. It's very, very important, right? So it is good to maintain cordial relationship with the media people so that your value delivery system could be enhanced in a better way. Third type of public, government public, the lawmakers. The decisions taken by the lawmakers, the new rules or laws, you know, they bring out could greatly influence your decisions and activities. Sometimes a new law which is passed could even ban your business. They are so powerful. The legal environment and the government public is so powerful, and it greatly influences all your decisions, not only marketing, all the decisions. So, your managers or the team of people should closely monitor what is happening in the government and what regulations they are going to bring out, in what way they are going to influence it on the activities of your company. That should be taken care. Then citizen action public, they are the people who question the activities of a firm. Social activists, people who are in charge of consumer forum, consumer clubs, right? And so if they find any activities in which your company involves which really affect the interests of the public or affect the particular interest of a particular segment of the people, and they will try to create problems, or they will try to raise up the issues through the media or through the legal infrastructure available, they will go to court and file a case against your company. So that is very important, citizen action public. Local public, supporting the existence of the firm. The people who are in the neighborhood of your organization, your production plant. I remember when I was in abroad, the education of many students is to be sponsored by the companies in their neighborhood. They are mining companies. They have nothing to do with the education of the people in the surrounding. But it's like out of corporate social responsibility or interest, or to get their support for the survival of the organization, existence of the organization in their locality, and they try to finance their studies. Because education is very costlier in other countries. It's very, very costlier in other countries, not like in India. And that is why they have exit points, and 3 levels of exit points for a degree. You complete the first year, you get the diploma. If you complete the second year, you get associate degree of business. If you complete the third year, you get the bachelor degree. And then the general public contribute for the firm's image building. Very important. They are the society. So you cannot afford to concentrate only on your target customers. You should also build a kind of a good image in the minds of the general public. They are non-consumers for your product, but even a person who never consumed your product could create a lot of issues against the company. It's very important. I'm sure you would have heard about the problem faced by Coca-Cola in India once. And the government went to the edge of banning Coca-Cola. Many educational institutions stopped selling Coca-Cola in their food court. And in many government departments, Coca-Cola was banned. So followed by Pepsi. It's also a cola drink. You know, it was banned. It's just because of an issue raised by one person saying that Coke is preferred using contaminated water. It consists, it contains pesticides. Then Coke, its public relations department, took a lot of efforts to put off whether it is a rumor or an issue, and it gave advertisement, making use of the cinema celebrities. In the advertisements, the advertisements were picturized in the factory itself, and they telecasted how, in a professional way or meticulously, Coca-Cola is manufactured, right, in a hygienic environment. And that's what about. And they kept on saying, quite a lot of things that, it is a brand which is consumed by so many people around the world, and for very many years it has been serving the people for generations together, and quite a lot of information they had to share with the people to convince them that it is a rumor. So this is what, those are the power of general, then internal public, the people who are within you in the company, your employees, the management, they decide the destiny of the firm, I tell you. Unless you win the cooperation of your internal customers, the employees, through proper internal marketing. We'll have a separate video for internal marketing and internal customers as well. So they decide the destiny. If they don't cooperate with your organization, I'm sure your organization cannot really think of success. With that, let me wind up. Thanks for watching this video.